Hello dear learners, in today's tutorial we'll show how to conduct linear regression using the software Stata. First we'll show using OLS through menu option and later we'll show how to use command option. Let's open Stata software. So you can see this is the Stata software, and let's go to the data file. From here you can see we have two variables. One is stat subject marks, which we denoted as stat marks. Another one is study hour. So these are two variables. And our regression model y is equal to a plus bx. So y is our dependent variable. Our dependent variable is stat marks. A means intercept and B is the beta coefficient, and X is our independent variable, which is study hour. So we want to see whether there is functional relationship between stat marks and study hours. So our research hypothesis is study hour positively affect stat marks. That means the higher you spend for study, we expect that the higher stat marks you will achieve. Let's do this analysis in Stata. Remember, here we have used only one independent variable, so it will be simple linear regression. Okay, so to conduct this regression, you need to go to the statistics, and under statistics, you see there is option for linear model and related, and then you need to click linear regression. And under dependent variable, you need to put your dependent variable, which is stat marks, and your independent variables is study hour, and you just click OK. So you will get this result. So we have total observation 2380, so this is the total number of students, and using this sample we get this result. So let's explain the output. So this is the study hour, that is your independent variable, and your coefficient value is 1.57 and it is positive. So this means for 1 hour increase in study hour, the mean increase in stat subject marks is 1.57. And this result, if you see whether it supports your hypothesis, yeah, it supports your hypothesis, because this p-value, this is less than 1%, or even it is less than 0.001%, so it is highly statistically significant. And this is the value of the constant or intercept, and this is based on hypothetical data. So next is probability of AP statistics. So this is the model significance. You can see this, the model is also statistically significant. And this adjusted R square is 0.0769. So that means about 7.69% variation in your dependent variable can be explained by the variation in independent variable. So this is the nutshell of the interpretation of your output. Here we have used only one independent variable. However, we may ask the question that stat marks may not be only affected by the study hour, there could be some other variables. So we need to use some control variables as well. So when you use these control variables in addition variables that may affect your stat marks or dependent variables, you need to run multiple linear regression. So next we'll conduct multiple linear regression. Let's see how can we do this. Now this is your data file. So I have added two additional control variable. One is IQ score, so I think that stat marks, how much you get the marks in your stat subject, that may also depend your IQ level or IQ score of the student. Or another variable, this is actually, you can see here, learning disability. So learning disability may also affect your stat marks. So these two are additional control variables. So you now see you have now three explanatory variables. So I can now rewrite our model. So our model becomes stat marks, that is a dependent alpha plus beta 1, and your first independent variable is study hour plus beta 2. Now you got second explanatory variable IQ score plus beta 3. This is we called learning disability. So we have more than one explanatory variable. We need to conduct multiple linear regression. Here, one important thing, while this stat marks, study hour, IQ score, these are continuous variable, but learning disability, you see, we decode it is as a 0 and 1, so it is a binary variable, binary dummy variable. 0 means this student has no learning disability, and 1 means this student has learning disability. So among these variables, this one is the dummy variable, that is learning disability. Okay, so to run this multiple linear regression, you go to the statistics, linear model and related, and then linear regression. And you need to put your dependent variable, that is stat marks, and your independent variable, study hour, IQ score, and learning disability. However, when you put your learning disability, that means dummy variable here, or categorical variable here, you need to put I dot before your dummy variable. So you need to type what? I dot. So it indicates it is a categorical variable. And then you press OK, you will get this result. Now you can explain this output similarly to the previous one. Like from this coefficient table, you can see the study hour, it is the positive, and the value is 1.598673. So for 1 hour increase in study hour, the mean stat subject marks increases by 1.59, while other variables remains constant. And similarly, you can see the IQ score is also positively related. And your learning disability, this is your control variable, and this is a dummy one. And it is minus one. So this means those who have learning disability, they get on an average 1.74 marks less than those students who has no learning disability. And in all cases, our results are statistically significant. So you can see the p-value, it is less than 1%. And this model is also statistically significant. You can see it is less than 0.001 or less than 1%. And your adjusted R squared is 0.1118. So you can say that about 11.18 variation in your dependent variable can be explained by the total variation in your independent variable. So in this way, we can easily conduct the regression in the Stata. Now, one of the advantages of the Stata that I would suggest to follow is using the command option. I think that is much easier if you grab this thing. So the command option is very simple. So instead using this menu option, I can use the command option. So for a regression, just type reg. Reg is the abbreviation of the regression, and after the reg you place your variable. So first I need to put our dependent variable statmarks. So if you click here, so statmarks, and then you click study our IQ score learning disability. So I'm contacting regression, and this is a common function, and you will get the similar result. So previously I didn't put dummy one, but it doesn't matter here because we already indicated this as a dummy previously. So if you press I dot in learning disability, it will give you the same result.